making a push to thoroughly examine the reports that Russian hackers tried to influence the presidential election to help Donald Trump. It comes on the heels of the reported CIA conclusion that Moscow did indeed meddle in our election, raising some widespread concerns this morning about Vladimir Putin's intentions. Here's Senator John McCain.
There's a whole lot of issues out there. It requires an investigation. The president has ordered an investigation for that. You're not going to find all this out in the next month.
And joining us now is Ambassador John Bolton, former UN ambassador to the United Nations, senior fellow at the American Enterprise Institute, Fox News contributor, who is on the list for a possible Secretary of State. Ambassador, welcome as always.
Glad to be with you.
You know, many say that Russian influence and the invasion of our election system on behalf of Donald Trump, supposedly, as has been alleged, would be an outrageous invasion of our country, of our sovereignty, deeply offensive threat to our national security and the very tenets of this republic. So what should we do?
Well, I think it is important to determine the facts first. According to the media, as recently as this morning, the FBI has one view, the CIA may have a different view, and obviously out here in the public, we have no idea what the underlying facts are. But I would say this. Any effort by any foreign government to influence an American election is a direct assault on the Constitution. It's something we have always worried about, going back to George Washington's administration, when the ambassador from revolutionary France, Citizen Genet, came to this country and openly tried to build coalitions with people who wanted a more pro-French foreign policy, more anti-British foreign policy. This was a searing lesson for the early republic. And I think if the facts prove out that Russia did try to influence our election, they should face very grave consequences, both so they never even think about it again and so that nobody else ever thinks about it again.
What type of grave consequences? You know, the potential candidate for Secretary of State, Mr. Tillerson, in the past has been against sanctions on Russia. Would you support sanctions? What do you think we should do?
Well, that's why I say we have to know the facts here, and it's not at all clear to me, just viewing this from the outside, that this hacking into the DNC and the RNC computers was not a false flag operation. Let's remember what FBI Director James Comey said dealing with Hillary's homebrew server. He said, "We found no direct evidence of foreign intelligence service penetration. But given the nature of this, we didn't expect to," meaning a really sophisticated foreign intelligence service would not leave any cyber fingerprints. And yet people say they did leave cyber fingerprints in the hacks regarding our election. So the question that has to be asked is, why did the Russians run their smart intelligence service against Hillary's server, but their dumb intelligence service services against the election?
When you say false flag, that's a very serious charge. I mean, false flag by whom? Here's the Washington Post. The Post reported the CIA has concluded that individuals with close ties to the Russian government hacked the emails. Intelligence officials have determined that Russia's goal was to help Trump win rather than simply undermine confidence in the election. Are you actually accusing someone here in this administration of trying to, or in the intelligence community, of trying to throw something?
We just don't know. But I believe that intelligence has been politicized in the Obama administration to a very significant degree.
But would the agents, the intelligence officials, politicize this to go so far to something that could potentially damage the very issue of our republic and what we for 200 plus years have stood for?
Well, now I think the whole thing is called into question, which is why the notion of some kind of independent investigation becomes extremely important. I do think it's critical to answer the question I posed. If you think the Russians did this, then why did they leave fingerprints?
Maybe because that's how we have such sophisticated ability to
Except James Comey and the FBI couldn't find any fingerprints in Hillary's.
Well, they use a different standard. It's been shown that they have a criminal standard, while the CIA has more of an intellectual deduction.
And let's hear that debate. Let's hear the debate.
What do you want to say? What do you want to hear? Something from the CIA director?
Yeah, I'd like to know. I mean, I think we've got something now. We don't want to compromise intelligence sources and methods. But when you make that kind of allegation, if it were true, and I believe the Russians have both the capability and the intention of doing it, I'm not by any means trying to exonerate them, but if you say they've done that, let me be very clear. Either in the cyber world or elsewhere, we should retaliate. It is unacceptable for the American Constitution to be assaulted by foreigners in that way. So it is absolutely critical as well that we get the facts right on this. And I don't think we have anywhere enough in the public domain to know what the facts are.
The president has ordered a review. The Senator McCain and others of the Armed Services Committee are having a hearings on this with the new Congress. Let me read you a statement from both Senators McCain, Senators Graham, Schumer, and Jack Reed of Rhode Island, both bipartisan. For years, American foreign adversaries have directed cyber attacks at America's physical, economic, and military infrastructure while stealing our intellectual property. Now our democratic institutions have been targeted. Recent reports of Russian interference in our election should alarm every American. This cannot become a partisan issue. The stakes are too high for our country. McCain this morning called Putin a thug, a killer, and a murderer. The president has ordered this public review. What are you calling on the president now to do before January 20th? To reveal the classified information, to bring it all out so Americans can finally know if Russia did indeed have a hand in this election?
Well, one thing that makes me very nervous is Barack Obama saying, let's have this report before the 20th of January so that I can wrap it up. I think the burden, for well or ill, is going to fall on Mike Pompeo, who's been named as President-elect Trump's CIA director. I think he's trusted by Republicans and Democrats alike. He doesn't bring any baggage to this. He's coming in as a new official at the CIA. I'd look to him to head up an investigation across the entire intelligence community. I just think these are such serious charges. Again, if the Russians or any other foreign government think that they can undermine the integrity of our elections or defeat our constitutional process, this is just as serious an attack as a military
and
attack.
And to those who are very bothered by your claim of a potential false flag, I mean, that's incredibly serious to say that and very disturbing as an American.
Well, we would want to know who else might want to influence the election and why they would leave fingerprints that point to the Russians. That's why I say until we know more about how the intelligence community came to this conclusion, we don't know whether it's Russian-inspired or a false flag.
Well, the CIA reportedly has said that they believe it's the Russians, so as we'll see as this investigation continues. Finally,